Hello guys, I'm Kiri, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna talk about the Italian beauty from the 70s and early 80s, a Maserati Merak. The car was in production from 1972 to 1983, and for these 11 years just 1830 were made. This makes this car very rare. Just for example, I'm gonna say Lamborghini Aventador is more than 10,000 times made and is still in production. Lamborghini Gallardo, more than 14,000. Hurricane, more than 10,000. Ferrari 360, more than 17,000. Ferrari Testarossa, more than 10,000. So guys, just 1,830 is very, very small number of cars. And really today the car is very, very rare. So this was a mid-engine 2+2 sports car and was very similar to the other very special Maserati model, Maserati Bora. The two cars are the same up to the B pillar, just the rear side are different. The chassis is the same as well, both cars sharing the same chassis, Maserati Bora and Maserati Merak. But instead of Bora's V8, big engine 4.7 liter, here we have more compact V6 3-liter engine, which is longitudinally mounted with the differential and the gearbox on the back. So the interesting fact about the gearbox is the gearbox is from Citroën SM. You can see here the gearbox on the tail, on the backside. The front of the gearbox is the differential and then the engine. So the engine is little bit on front of the tires, and the tires are Michelin, the back tires 205/70x15" tires. So how I said, the gearbox is from Citroën SM, because on that time, from 1968 to 1975, Citroën was the owner of Maserati. And they've been using lots of Citroën parts as well. So Maserati Merak was using lots of Citroën parts. For example, the hydropneumatic system, the brakes, the clutch, been using the same pneumatic assistance. Also the pop-up headlights being connected with the same pneumatic system. But after 1976, when Citroën gave up the Maserati, these parts they've been changed by different parts. And then 1977, Alejandro De Tomaso take the control over the Maserati. The first thing he did was to stop Maserati Bora of the production. So after just 600 cars made, even Maserati Bora was much more small number than Merak, just 600. So he stopped producing Maserati Bora. But this was the time when the petrol crisis, and because of the Italian law for the low taxes, so they start Maserati using small engines, just 2 liters. Also, like Ferrari and Lamborghini on the same time, they make V8 engine with small capacity, just 2 liters. Actually the block was the same, they just make the cylinders smaller. So from 2-3 liters they make it 2 liters. You can see here the backside of the car, the tires, the wheels, they are Italian alloy wheels, Campagnolo, 7.5x15", with the tires Michelin, of course. The size of the rear tires, how I said before, 205/70x15, and this line on the middle of the car is amazing. This was usual for the Italian cars of this area, because all the Italian designers, they've been using this line. Ferrari used, Lamborghini as well. You can see here the back seats, the car is 2+2, the back seats, but they are very small for very small kids or just to put the luggage. And here is something very special, the label Italian, from Itau design and designer Giorgetto GUIGIARO. So this label is actually very, very important, because how we know, the Italian design is something very special. And this front grille on the bonnet, the black grille between the pop lights, we're gonna talk about a little bit later about this grille, is specially for the model with the model SS. You can see here the grille, the black grille between the pop lights, is for the model SS only. So we was talking about the small engine 2 liter, so just 200 cars were made with the 2 liter engine, and the model was Maserati Merak 2000 GT. The power was 170 horsepower, so this small engine 2 liter with 3 carburetors as well. But let's go back to the V6 3-liter engine. The first Merak with the 3-liter engine from 1972 was with 190 horsepower. You can see here the tires, 205/70 VR15, the front tires, but I think this is not the correct size for the front tires. They should be 185 or 195/70x15. So 205 is for the rear tires, but here I'm not exactly 100% sure, but so the first Merak was with 190 horsepower with the 3 twin carburetors Weber with compression ratio 8.7 to 1. The maximum speed of this Maserati Merak was 240 kilometers per hour. Only 630 of these early models Maserati Merak were made, and the production ended in 1974. And then, how is it, from 1972 to 1974 was the first edition Maserati Merak, and then came the more special Maserati Merak SS. So actually this is Maserati Merak SS is the car from the video what you're watching. This was a little bit different by the early version. It came in 1975 and was 50 kilograms lighter than the early version, and not only that, was 30 horsepower more. So the engine was pumped up to 220 horsepower. Just have a look, this side of the car is so beautiful. It's so beautiful with this grills on the bonnet, the engine to for the air cooling the engine, the hot air to take the way from the engine bay. And you can see here the interior of the car. And the owner of this car actually was very kind, very nice owner, and he liked to talk about the car, and he showed me the car from the inside, the interior of the car. And was so beautiful inside. You can see the seats, everything is just was dream for that time. You can see the handbrake is on the right side, and the owner said he want to keep the original, the car as much as original, just was restoring outside, but inside he preferred to keep the leather original, because still 40 years later the leather smell like is from the factory, is from that time, because the Italian leather, everyone knows the Italian leather is something very special. It's very beautiful. And how I said, the owner was very nice, kind person to explain about the car. Was nice restored outside, not big restoration. You see here the inside, the clusters looks absolutely amazing. Very beautiful car. And how I said, we've been talking about the Maserati Merak SS with the 220 horsepower. These 30 extra horsepower, they came from different carburetors, and the compression ratio was moved to 9.1. So the early version was 8.75. Here we have 9.1. The exterior was the same car from the exterior, just how I said, the difference was with this black plastic grille between the front pop lights. The interior of the car was different as well from the early version, the SS model was with different clusters inside, different design of the dashboard as well. And in total, from the Merak SS, there were 1,000 units made. So, how I said, from the early version 630, from the SS 1,000 units, and the production of the car ended in 1983. So, with 1,830 cars made, the Maserati Merak is very rare car even today, but is not highly appreciating today because it's entry level super sport car on that time. The car was on the same sector with Ferrari 208, 308 GT4 and Lamborghini Huracán 200 GT, 250 GT or 300 GT. So it was on the same sector with these Italian cars and as well the same sector with Porsche 911 and Lotus Esprit. So how you can see from different angles on the back side, on the front side, the car looks very pretty with the Italian design, of course, Italian very famous designer Giorgetto GUIGIARO from Italo Design. He make lots of nice sports cars on that time. And here also you can see the spoiler on the back, on the bottom side of the under the bumper, black spoiler. It looks very nice. And how I said, the grill, the black grill between the pop lights. This is usual for the model Maserati Merak SS. The engine of the Maserati Merak, after that, was used to well-known model Maserati Biturbo and Maserati Ghibli. The same, the engine was originally 2.7 liter and was created for the Citroën SM and designed by Giulio Alfieri, the Italian, another great engine designer, Giulio Alfieri, but then was enlarged to 3 liters for the Maserati Merak. And you can see here the tire, the wheel Campagnolo, 7.5 by 15, and how is it, 195/70 by 15. This is more correct size front tire, 195/70 by 15, Michelin, of course. The chassis is still monocoque, and the rear souped frame for the engine and the gearbox. The brakes were all discs on the four wheels, and the wheels were, how I said, the Italian alloy wheels Campagnolo, 7.5 by 15 inch with the Michelin tires on it. As well, this back side of the car with the grills. Today, Ford GT makes something similar, but it's more for the aerodynamic efficiency. Here we have as well chrome bumpers, very, very nicely made, very small bumper, very fine, amazing with these lights as well, the exhausts, they are stainless steel as well, just looks amazing, this car, even today. I said it's not very highly appreciated, but it's an affordable car, so it is very beautiful Italian cars from the 70s and early 80s. So guys, I hope you like the video about the Maserati Merak, and please subscribe my channel, and see you next time guys, bye!